culmination of 2 years of hard work. Don't let anyone ever tell you that GCSE students don't work hard.
And this is work that's sort of set in the syllabus over the last 2 years, and this is the culmination of that work, is it?
It is, yeah. We do fine art and applied art, which is vocational art. They're both full GCSEs. They work over 2 years, produce a lot of coursework, and then they have their exam. They get the paper in January and sit the exam in March.
To the layman, what's the difference between fine art and applied art?
Applied art is working to a brief, so you're producing something for a client. You might be asked to produce perhaps a T-shirt and a CD for a group or a band of which is what they were asked to do of their choice.
It must be a very proud moment for you to see your work on display like this, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
And how sort of long a period of time are we talking about? How long has it taken you to create all this stuff?
It's from year 10, so 2 years.
Which of the works are you most proud of, do you think?
That'll be my stained glass window.
Okay. Is this art something you really enjoy?
Yeah, I do. I love it.
Do you?
Mm-hmm.
Is it something you're looking forward to maybe in the future that you can do as a career?
Sadly, no.
You got something else in mind, have you?
Yeah.
Okay. And what aspect of art do you like the best? What sort of art do you like?
More the designing bit. I love the designing bit and just brainstorming all the different ideas you could do. That's what I love about it.
Okay. And what's the exhibition really about today, don't you think?
I think it's about showing off all our hard work so people could just appreciate what we've been doing for the past 2 years.
Okay.
It was enjoyable, but it was a lot of hard work.
What was the hardest part, would you say, for you?
The hardest was the practical work. We got a lot of homework to take home, which was very time consuming. But my final piece took a lot of work, which is this one here.
I bet it did. And is it something, a subject you really enjoyed?
Yeah, I did really enjoy it. It was really good.
Besides some resistant materials, what exactly to the layman, what does that mean?
That means working in a range of materials from wood, metal, plastics, and any other materials, really, if they're appropriate. I mean, you could use concrete if it was appropriate, or fabrics to a certain extent.
So what's the idea then? What are you trying to get the kids to do? Just to use their imaginations to use various objects?
Yeah, that's right. They're trying to, based on the limited knowledge they do have, because, you know, I mean, they've only been in the school 5 years, and they don't do technology the whole year through, and get half a year. So with their limited experience, they are trying to use appropriate materials. They're designing something and then either using wood, metal or plastic or a combination of materials and trying to use the most appropriate or the best materials for the tasks that they've designed.
You've got some wonderful objects here. I noticed an old radio there. Is that something that's been made from scratch or just been recycled?
No, it's been made from scratch, and it's meant to, because the project that was set by the exam board was to design and make a small storage unit based on any design era from the last 100 years, and she happened to pick the 1930s. And so she designed a storage unit which is made to look like a radio. So it's actually the bit at the bottom where you've got the tuning dials is actually a drawer.
Oh, I see.
And the other bit lifts up, so it's for storing jewellery and bits and pieces.
That's wonderful, and the phone as well. You've got some excellent stuff. They must warm the cockles of your heart when you see
it. It does, actually. It's been an extremely motivated year group. We've produced some really nice stuff this year. I'm hoping for quite a lot of high grades.
Ed and Emily, what are you doing here? You don't come back to school, surely. Why are you here today?
We were invited to come look around.
See our teachers, look at other people's artwork.
Yeah. And this is you 2 years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah. Yep.
So what's happened to you since then? Where have you been and what have you been up to?
I've been at South East Essex College doing an art and design course, and we've just finished.
Yeah.
And did really well. So, just came back to see and talk to other pupils.
So, you are a little bit of gratitude to the teachers here then for giving you sort of inspiration to
move on. Yeah,
definitely.
And art's a really good subject for you, both of you, and you really enjoyed doing that, yeah?
Yeah, no, it's our favourite subject, and we always wanted to stay behind school and do some more with our teachers.
The amount of time we spent lunches in the studio.
Well, that's superb. And what's going to happen to you next? What are you going to do career-wise?
I have no idea what I want to do still.
Well, how about art teaching? There's a thought.
I did actually think about that at one point.
Teacher Emily.
What about you, Heather?
I don't know. I'd quite like to do something with graphics, but currently I'm going on to a foundation year to decide what I want to do, and then university, and then a year out, and then a master's, and then teaching, maybe. I don't know.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for taking the time to talk to us, and enjoy the exhibition.
Thank you.
With the vocational art, they do use a variety of media. You know, have to have graphic skills, use Photoshop, we've done enamelling, silk painting, and the fine artists are encouraged to use photography and film as well as painting, and you know, more conceptual and installation type art as well.
Okay, we've just spoken to one of your students who's inspired enough to go to be in, wants to be in the counter. But how many of your students have said, "Yeah, I really enjoyed art and I'd like to continue"?
I think you'd be surprised. I would say there are probably about 3/4 of them who are going on to do some kind of art qualification. Some will be doing art or photography or media with A levels, and others are going straight on to do fashion design or filmmaking.
There's been a lot of criticism recently in the press about GCSEs being too easy or too hard. Where does art fall into that category? Would you say I've got it just about right, the standard they set? Or?
Yes, I think so. I mean, I think it's been, you know, it's changed quite a few times since I started doing it. I think they've got it just about right now. I don't think they will be changing art because, you know, we're heavily reliant on coursework and it's a big part of what we do. And I think it probably is just about right. You get offered several options when you take your exam, so it suits, you know, the less academic pupils or the less able pupils as well as the high flyers.
Okay, so what happens to all this art now? Is it for sale, or do the kids take it home with them?
I'm sure if somebody wanted to buy it, they'd be quite happy. hoping to keep it up for a bit longer so the rest of the school can have a look at it after the parents and everybody else who's been invited tonight. Then we pack it away and they come and collect it when they get their coursework in the autumn.
And we'll see you again next year when next year's year 11 do the same thing.
Yeah, hopefully.
Thank you for taking the time to talk to us.
Okay, thanks very much for coming.